I do smoke a lot of pot. That's the truth. All right. It's fun, right? But I'm not going to pretend like it has no bad effects whatsoever. You know, those guys who are like, oh no, it's totally medicinal. It's just sent here to heal us by the thunder spirit. Okay, well then the thunder spirit also wants me to lose 7 hats in 3 months. And he loves it when the Corn Chex box goes right in the fridge. That is huge. And when your girlfriend leaves you because you left her front door wide open for 2 days so you could see the Black Keys in Milwaukee, the thunder spirit's like, shit, my work here is done. Now, a lot of people fight the battle between alcohol and pot, and I absolutely believe pot is better for you than alcohol. Pot has never made me violent. It's never made me nauseous. But it did make me play bass in a jam band for 5 years because I thought we were going to make it. That's a bad effect. And that didn't just affect me. That affected all of our listeners. Of whom there were dozens. Because my band answered the burning musical question, what would fish sound like if 2 of the 4 members could not play their instruments? And fish answers the musical question, what would it sound like if Genesis and Frank Zappa got together to ruin the White Album? Now, I can say that because I saw 10 fish shows. I've given those guys plenty of money, right? I was a hippie. I saw the Fish. I saw Widespread Panic. I saw the Dead. I saw the Allman Brothers. I was a hippie for 3 years. I got out right when I started to lose my hair because, well, you got to. It is a very hair-centric subculture. They don't have a place for this. If you think this looks bad in a V-neck, you should see it with no shirt and a hemp necklace. It's not... You should start losing your hair as a hippie. You see that first hair go out, you're like, well, time to get into rancid because this is not working. Your brain won't even conceive of a bald hippie. It won't do the math. We don't consider Hunter Thompson to be a hippie. Even though he wrote Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas, he lived with the Hells Angels for a year, he did acid with the Merry Pranksters in 1967, but he was bald, so he was just like a weirdo or something. We don't have a category for that. Have him played by Johnny Depp. I don't know. He's a weird dude. But there was one guy on the hippie circuit that I want to talk about because he's a guy that everybody hated, right? And that was the trust fund hippie, right? Everyone's like, fuck that guy. He's just spending his father's money. That's why he gets to go to these festivals. What a fucking dick. And the trust fund kid is not only in the hippie world. He's following Skrillex around Europe right now. He's taken 3 improv classes at once, and nobody knows how he can do it without a day job. And the minute they find out he's a trust fund kid, man, they turn on him. What a fucker, what a dick, I hate that guy. Why hate him? Why not love him? Right? Yes, he is spending his father's money on burritos and hotel rooms. Yes, he is doing that. But that is evil rich guy money. Those are the most moral things that money's ever gonna fund. Yes, I hope he blows all of it. Right? So it can never be spent on toxic assets and credit default swaps and mortgage-backed securities and other things that can be sold to your father's company and begin to destroy his pension fund. Let's keep that fucker spending all that money. Let's keep him distracted before his evil rich guy DNA kicks in and he goes fucking, he gets rid of all this stupid hippie shit and goes back to work with his old man destroying America. If you know a trust fund hippie, send him a box of drugs tomorrow. We need to keep him out there. Think where this country might be with just 2 more years of George W. Bush still doing coke in the Dallas disco circuit. He couldn't have invaded Iraq. He couldn't have fucked up Katrina. The worst he could have done is like fuck up the Texas Rangers for a couple more seasons. Keep Hitler painting as long as you possibly can. possibly can. Thank you for coming out. See you guys in a little bit. Good night.